Zombie Apocalypse. Hello everyone and welcome in new gold farming video. Today we are continuing our series where we farming every single dungeon in Classic WoW for 50 runs or like for 5 hours. And after that we discussed the route I took, the drops, and we sold anything from last week, transmog farming or not. So this week we farmed stockades. I wanted to get out of the way stockades because together with Ragefire Castle it's worst dungeon for transmog farming. Still, I think the Ragefire Castle is a bit better because it has more items that are valuable. So let's start. I will show you now. Probably all of you know where the stockades are. They are located in Stormwind. So for Alliance, it's really easy. Just teleport there. For Horde players, you need to take Zeppelin from Orgrimmar to Gromgold base camp in Strangthorn Vale. So then you fly to Stormwind City. Dungeon is here, it's easy one. You can do it any class. I will show you now the route I took and after that we will discuss the loot. As you could see, the dungeon is really easy to run and you can run it with any class, it doesn't matter which one, you will make it in like 3 to 4 minutes for sure. So really really easy one. So I will show you the loot one. There is only one item that you want to aim in stockades and that's Buccaneer's Vest. Its market value 12k on my realm, regional 16.5k. It's really good sell rate, it sells really fast, it's good item. But problem is with stockades that it doesn't drop any more items that are really valuable. So this is only one and there are much better items, much better places that you can farm Buccaneer's Vest and you can get also better items than here. Because if we watch everything that we got, you get also a lot of rings with really fake. So market value, for example this one 2k. Never ever you are going to sell it for 2k. This one for example 6k market value on my realm, also no way to sell it for that price. So shields we kept only because if someone is collecting shields it can happen that we sell them, and it's also they are low value. Most of those items we kept because we are first starting with transmogs. So we did only Ragefire Castle before and we need items on auction house because more auctions you have, more sales you have. And usually I don't keep items that are under 500 gold. Here in this case we are keeping also low value items because we need those items, we need to get sales to build the bank. So also the forest letter pieces drops here, it's like you get almost like every piece here in this dungeon in stockades, but they are low value, they have bit better so sell rate than the most of the other items, but it's nothing special. Seer's Robe also I kept because people tend to buy this. Also this one because it's only like sweater like items, one of the few that looks like sweater in the game, so that's why the people buy them. Rings, no way that we sell them. Maybe we sell them, we will try, but I don't think they will sell, not for this price for sure. You get also a lot of patterns here in this dungeon, so they are pretty bad like sell rate. Some of them like this one is okay, but the price is a bit overpumped. We kept also few of them. I hope we get some sales. I kept also Shadow Gem. It's only 7 gold market value, but intends to sell. Also Mossagate is 62 gold market value. Those are 8 gold market value, so I kept them so we earned some gold. So as you see, it's really nothing special. Everything together it's 62k market value, but no way that we can get nowhere near to this value from those items here. We will post them on auction house and we will check next week did we sell anything of them. And over the next few weeks you will also see that do we sell them or not, because we are going to farm also other dungeon, and every week we are going to check auction house did we sold anything that we farmed. So now we will send everything from those items to my bank vault, and we will check what we sold from last week. So for stockades, really I don't recommend you to farm it. So let's check what we sold last week. So here we are on my back out. So let's check now. It's really bad. We sent those items to our alt to sell. As you can see, so those where you see 1. Something k, that's that we earned like raw gold and from vendoring trash items from stockades. So in it's like 1.2k per hour around that. From last week we sold only one pattern for 121 gold. So then we sold this one, it's shield, for 67 gold. It's also really bad. Another pattern 48 gold, and two formulas for enchanting for 11 gold. So everything together it's like 250 gold, not more. So it's really bad. It's really good for you to see this, because you want to see over the time when you get more transmog items, how do you sell even more and more transmogs. This is only with 40 transmogs on auction house from Reishvar Kassen, so it's nothing. To really get to good sales you need minimum 1k transmog items on auction house. You will see over the time when we get more and more transmogs how we will be made even more and more per week. It's really important for you to see this, because if you want to farm transmogs you want to do it for a long run. Overnight you can turn nothing. When also when you see videos where it says like 400, 500, 600k in 1 hour, so it's market value. First of all, you never get that gold, that amount of gold, and second, it takes time to sell, as you are going to see over the time here. So this will be it for stockades. Next week it's going to be more interesting than this week and past week, because Reishvar Kassen and stockades are two worst dungeons for transmog farming. From next week it's going to be more interesting also for me to farm. So probably next week I'm going to do Wailing Caverns 50 runs or 5 hours. So if you liked the video and you want to support me, you can subscribe to my channel. It's going to help me a lot. Thanks everyone for watching, and see you in the next one. Bye bye.